fucking with. Roll out airman.
Sagan, are you gonna dance? Sagan, are you gonna dance? Sadie's still sleepy. It's a Sadie. You're a little magician. I don't know how you got Nutri-Grain bar on my glasses, but you did it. And all my blankets, and all over me, and all over mommy's floor. You little punk. Wait, is that Zimmer Dutch to pick up the Aeon? Apparently they think she must have pink eyes. And they choose 20 minutes before school lets out to tell us to pick her up. And I have to be at work in just under an hour. Lines if I stay in the place for work. That would be good. Hopefully these new work pants will work, because right now I am worried that they are a little too low. I need to find my super long tank tops and wear them so that I'm covered. But what you get. Nikki and Aeon should be back out soon. There's more lines. More lines. More lines. Why can't you ever stay straight?
White dress, black tie, this place about to blow and you're the dynamite. Your friends know all of them come around, everybody needs a guardian. I'm through feeling lost, cause I found you. The people around you surround you.
So I'm sitting here similar prep niceness for going to a wedding tomorrow, whatever. And I was like, I should repaint these with, just take care of my nails in general, right? I was getting so hard, I was like, why isn't it clipping the, why is it not, you know? And then, you know, all of a sudden I hear a noise and something was very wrong. And I'm just like, what happened? The top piece of the nail clipper just broke off. Just freaking broke off. And then when I was trying to like see whether it was broken or if it just was like an extra piece that fell off, this part just decided to drop off, followed by this part, piece falling out. So the whole thing is just useless now. It's just a bunch of crap. It's just useless now. So much for that. Anyway, I'm going to return to watching Cassandra's vlogs and painting this with Commander in Chief. Just this feather cover. And this isn't even like the first fantastic thing that's happened when I've been like working on this. Like, I first went to try on the outfit that I wanted to wear for tomorrow, which is the purple dress with the beret and heels that I did the other day when I did the fancy makeupness. And since the dress has that little like cinch in it sort of thing, like where the bottom of the dress, the top half, the zipper got stuck because it's a side zipper. And I was having a tough time getting it on. It's not like it's too small, it's not too big or anything, it's just the way that seam is got stuck on there. And I think it may have been like a loose thread on the inside too. I just sit there and work at it to get it to go, to actually move, and then when I got it to go all the way up, the zipper part, the zips, just sort of ripped open. Because that's always fun when the zipper breaks. And then I had to go and ask Jeff for help, because the zipper was stuck up here, and all the side was open, and he was afraid he was going to break it, so I had to ask Lisa, and Lisa tried it, and she couldn't get it, so I had to sit there and take it off, and then give it back to her and get it, but thankfully she got it to work, and now the zipper works fine, so hopefully it won't give me problems tomorrow, because that would kind of suck. So, yeah. And then I finally just went ahead and got wedding gifts for them, because Jeff and I was in it, like, it's like not really much time. What do we do for a wedding gift when we're kind of saving money and stuff? And I looked a while ago and noticed that they had their sort of register thing on Amazon, I believe. But their whole list was on there. So I was like, okay. And most of it was like household items. Like general like things you need to have in a house sort of thing. So I was saying like, okay, I'll get them a gift card with whatever extra money I have from my paycheck. Because I have like almost 200 saved up out of the 400 that I need. And it's only the first week, so I'm like, yeah, I can splurge a little on this thing. So I have all $30 left for this paycheck. So it's like Amazon or Bed Bath & Beyond. And I was like, well, I'm not really sure just what all kind of stuff that would really be all that feasible to use a $30 gift card on. At Bath & Beyond, that would stretch very far. So I was like, I'll just give them an Amazon card. Because that way, it'll go farther. There's more things to choose from. There's nothing wrong with Amazon. So there's that. And then I was searching through cars and stuff, and I was like, none of these really fits. They're all like, you know, fancy, like, you know, they make me feel, think of like older couples, like, you know, late 20s-ish sort of thing, you know? And this is like, maybe it's too, it's too generic, or no, I don't feel like, I like the cards that I have to like, have some sort of like, you can kind of get a feeling as to who it's for or who it's from when I give it to people. So that's kind of what I look for. More so than necessarily just for like accurate message. So I looked through a bunch of those and I almost decided on one that was sort of like, it's kind of a long message on the outside and on the inside, but it was like kind of written in sort of like fairy tale sort of thing, and the writing was sort of like fairy tale sort of font to it and everything. So I was like, oh, they like to cosplay and stuff, and they like to go to the Renaissance Fair. I know those things, so I'm like, that actually might work. And then I found this other card, and I was like, that's it, we're done. This card, I know that Jeff and Matthew are like besties. Like, I feel weird saying they're besties because they're guys, but whatever. You know what? They're besties. So, I was like, this, you can tell this is from Jeff by reading this. So, that's why I chose it. And I imagine Matthew will get the joke as well. So, and the decoration on it is sort of like the kind of thing that like, I would do if I were to decorate a car. So I'm like, perfect. It's like a combination of me and Jeff in it, and then it's perfect for Matthew and them because it's like fun and lighthearted, but it's still a sort of like congratulations on your wedding card. So this is the front, which is an interesting sort of slightly girlish, you know, sort of thing. But it's sort of fun and funky and whatnot. And on the inside, I'm going to cover up the messages. This is the inside. Yeah, I think it works. I'm very satisfied with my choice there. And then since Cindy and Patrick are getting married at the end of the month, I decided I'll go ahead and get them a card as well, since I'm over here. And that was even harder, even because I do know them better. Like, I really wanted to be able to pick something that fit. So it like really kind of... That one really bugged me because they aren't really sort of messages and stuff, and a bunch of them are like, you know, they're like mentioning prayers and stuff, and you're just like, you don't really want to go that direction with it. So, kept looking for a little while, and I found one that was Gone with the Wind, and you know, Cindy loves Gone with the Wind. I was like, that's freaking awesome. But it was an anniversary one, like husband to wife slash wife to husband one. I was like, dang it. Well, why don't I look at it and read it and see if it still maybe could be passed off as a card that I could give them. And on the front, what it said It seems sort of like, oh, okay, this could work. Although right now I don't even remember just what it was that was on the phone, but it was a picture of Rhett and, God, did I actually forget her name? Scarlett. Rhett and Scarlett. I had Rhett and Scarlett on the front, and they had a speech bubble over each of them, but I don't remember what they were on the outside. And then on the inside, it's like, I greatly enjoyed another year of fiddle-dee-deeing around with you. And I was like, nope, can't do it. Can't give them that card. Won't fit. So, after tons of looking, this is the one I decided on for them. And it's kind of simple, it's kind of but it says, it's your story, make it beautiful. Fill it up with what you love, remember what matters, and forget what doesn't. So, and then I've had David and Jeff help me sign it, and I might also get Lisa to sign it, but I will definitely get whoever else in the house to sign that one. I only had Jeff and Lisa sign Matthew's card since Lisa lived with them for a while, so it's like, even though she's not going tomorrow, that way she's sort of, you know, is able to send a message, so, ta-da. So that's what I've done. I'm going to finish things and then go to bed because I have to get up early because there's a staff meeting tomorrow at Mohan, the last staff meeting I go to. So I have to be at Beth's house at 7:15 in the morning. And it's around 2 o'clock now, so that's going to be lovely. And then the wedding is at 2. I'm not sure how I'm going to do, like, what I would record and what I wouldn't. Maybe I'll get a little bit of something. I don't know what to expect since I haven't really been to a, like, formal sort of wedding other than... No, that's the one I was at. Michelle, stop. But it was like beach wedding, sort of casual-ish. But anyway, other than Michelle's wedding, I don't think I've been to any, like, formal-ish ones. Because Alex and Alyssa got married just by going to a quick house, and that's what Cindy and Patrick are doing. So, but it is. But, yeah, it's gonna be interesting. So, fun. And it's possibly good night now, since I don't know if I'll record more before I go to bed. So, yeah. Here goes nothing.